Hi folks, well, we're going to be doing some work on the P4 lighting plant project. As you can see, the rest of it's all stripped down now. I think I showed you last time, but I can't honestly remember. It's been so long since I've done anything with it. But all the switchgear is stripped out now. Well, that's another project there, by the way. Land Rover cat flap or tailgate, known as a cat flap amongst Land Rovery people. Yeah, so like I say, the rest of the lighting plants all stripped down, the base is there, it's all in bits now. A few bits and pieces that we've covered in previous videos. But what we're looking at today is the small end bush and pin. Here's a little test piece that I've made. Got about 1,500 clearance on that, which I'm quite happy with. Feels good. I was sent a new, well, good condition replacement pin. Thanks to that, Peter, if you're watching. The pin came out of a P55, which is a much larger Stuart Turner engine, a twin cylinder actually. Anyway, he shortened the pin for me, and it looks like it should do the job. This is the old bush and pin. As you can see, not in the greatest condition. We'll just chuck that up and I'll show you the amount of wear in it. Got a decent reamer, which is why I made the test piece, just to see that it was going to give the appropriate clearance. So yeah, we're going to get on and make that again, but properly this time. Just checking the measurement of the original small end bush before we make a new one. With the digital calipers, that's the reading. With the Moore and Wright micrometer, that's the reading I get, so that's the one I shall go for. More inclined to trust those. The first stage is just roughing out the outer diameter. Got quite a lot to take off. This was the nearest size bar that I could get. So we'll take some fairly large cuts, something like 15,000ths at a time. This bronze and the high speed steel tool can handle that quite okay. It's just a bit unpleasant. Fairly close to the required diameter, so we start being a bit more careful at this stage. Probably taking more like 5,000ths at a time. Having said these are not brilliant, we can use them just to see when we're getting close and take the final measurement with the micrometer. So there we are, 816 at the moment. We're aiming for 751 from memory. Thank you. If you can see that, I'd say that's pretty well spot on. Well, bear in mind that the lights in here are super efficient. The little 30 watt heater isn't even on. I think the lights use about 30 watts at most. The lathe motor is the only thing that really uses much power, and even that doesn't kick out a lot of heat. It's 10 degrees when I came in here an hour or so ago. Warms up pretty well. All the insulation was well worth it. Anyway, so what we're going to do now is just start to bore the inside diameter. What we'll do, we'll just take it out to something like 12 millimeters. Then I can part off the bearing. We can lose this section then and put this in the chuck, making the final boring operation just a little bit more accurate. So I'm just setting the length of the drill in the tailstock chuck, longer than the bush, and that way when we get up to the larger size of drills there'll still be enough clearance to part off and leave the size of material that we need. So we've sent the drill to the end of the material, so we can now very gently start drilling the pilot hole. I should add it's quite important to clear the drill at regular intervals, otherwise it will tend to snatch with the bronze. Brass is much the same once it clogs up. Don't really want a drill bit stuck in it. Such a high-pitched noise. Try not to use oil and bronze where I can help it. Just adds to the mess. That's it, and now we'll finish boring that with it in the chuck. So we're just finishing off with the drill. We've worked our way up to the 14mm size, what you call a blacksmith drill. So it's a bit shorter than an ordinary drill. Quite good for this sort of thing, they're pretty strong. Probably leave it about 10 thousandths over size of 14mm. So the final size we need is, from memory, 9/16 is about 14.2mm. So the reamer should just finish off the last bit. Half decent. So that's it, we just finish off the job with the reamer. I've just cleaned out the bore of the bush just to get rid of any swarf that may be in there. Hopefully we'll get a decent finish. So that's it, job done. Pins are a real nice fit in there. Not tight, but it just feels snug. So I think that'll be alright. Finished off with the hand reamer. Just drilled the oil holes in it. The pin's fitted now, replacement pin, perfect fit, feels really good, no unwanted movement, just all the right movement. Well, just when I thought I was done, just to add another twist to the story, it would seem the connecting rod is actually quite bent. In fact, when I set this up between centres, put a pin through there and then measured with it all set up between these machine surfaces, there was about an eighth of an inch difference in the measurement on each side. So this is even with a little bit of pressure on it, because I'm going to try and straighten it. So I probably just need to warm up the area I want to bend slightly. But yeah, it's pretty well out. I think it's just going to be a case of very slowly, little by little, see if we can line it up. It would explain the horrendous wear in the bore. So really it's a case of fix or bust. So I've applied some heat to that for about half an hour. I would say it's now as straight as it's ever going to get. In fact, I've just taken it slightly past the centre line because I'm pretty sure it's going to try and relax a little bit when I take the tension off it. And also bear in mind that because there's always a little bit of clearance, from memory is about 23,000ths gap there, which is pretty normal. The connecting rod is moved over, so it may not be entirely straight at this end. Anyway, so just taking it a little past the centre line should prove advantageous when we take the tension off. So we're going to let it cool down now, and fingers crossed. Well, we've been at it a fair while now, but we've succeeded. See what I mean about there being a little bit of play in the big end? That's normal. That is a new bearing as well. That's what you expect, because the loading on it is this way, not that way. Anyway, with the rule, when I get it right, held against that milled edge there and against the machine crank web, you see now that we have a nice straight connecting rod. What I had to do in the end was actually just bring it slightly past the centre line, as I expected, and as it cooled, it's now set nice and straight. well pleased with that. So we'll pull that out of there, clean it up, and call it a night, I think. Anyway, I hope the video's been of interest. Thank you very much for watching.